Karate is dangerous. You'll get brain damage. It's too violent for kids. Sound familiar? Well, what if I told you that you're statistically more likely to get injured driving to karate class than actually practicing karate? And that's just the beginning of what the science reveals. Today, I'm diving into over 30 peer-reviewed studies from 2020 to 2025 that completely shatter the myths about martial arts. And trust me, what researchers discovered will blow your mind. Welcome back to Health Science for All. Today, we're not talking opinions, we're talking cold hard data. I'm going to show you exactly what happens when scientists put karate practitioners in brain scanners, measure their bones, test their mental health, and track them for years. But first, let's address the elephant in the dojo. Canadian study by Zedaruk et al. 2005 tracked martial artists and calculated injury rates per 1,000 hours of actual training time. Here's what they found. Only 3.7 injuries per 1,000 hours of karate training compared to an average of 20, 30 injuries per 1,000 hours of soccer training, 127 injuries of ice hockey, and 7.10 injuries per 1,000 hours of car driving. Impressive? A German study by Jensen and Damen Zimmer 2012 tested how different activities, cognitive training, light exercise, and karate affect the health of older adults aged 67 to 93. All groups improved a little in thinking speed, but only the karate group showed a clear boost in emotional well-being. Those who practiced karate felt less depressed and reported greater self-worth compared to people who did no training. The researchers believe karate works because it combines physical movement, memory challenges from learning sequences, and the uplifting effects of teamwork and self-defense skills. The key takeaway? Learning karate, even at an advanced age, can improve quality of life and emotional health. Study #2, the school kid's brain boost. Reference, Lee et al. 2023, Martial Arts Enhance Working Memory and Attention in School-Age Children, a functional near-infrared spectroscopy study published in Journal of Experimental Child Psychology. Chinese scientists put brain scanners on kids while they did karate. They used something called functional near-infrared spectroscopy, basically watching the brain work in real time. What they found was incredible. After karate training, kids showed enhanced working memory, that's your brain's sticky note system, better attention, goodbye ADHD symptoms, increased brain activation in the right orbital frontal cortex, the decision-making center. But here's the kicker. Kids who just played games or rested, no brain changes at all. The meta-analysis that changes everything. Reference, Moore et al. 2020, The Effect of Martial Arts Training on Mental Health Outcomes, a systematic review and meta-analysis, published in Journal of Bodywork and Movement Therapies. This wasn't just one study, this was a meta-analysis. That's when scientists combine all relevant studies to see the big picture. They analyzed 28 studies total. Their conclusion? Martial arts training is an efficacious sports-based mental health intervention. Translation, it works for mental health. The depression and anxiety destroyer. Remember that meta-analysis? Here's what they found across all those studies. Significant improvements in well-being, reduced anxiety symptoms, lower depression rates, better emotional regulation. But let's get specific. Your bones get stronger. Reference, Drozd et al. 2018, karate training improves skeletal status assessed by quantitative ultrasound in girls and premenopausal women. Journal of Clinical Densitometry. Polish scientists studied 132 females doing karate. They used quantitative ultrasound to measure bone density. That's sound waves bouncing off your bones to see how strong they are. Results, karate practitioners had significantly higher bone density, better skeletal status, protection against osteoporosis. This is huge for women who are at higher risk for bone problems as they age. The Cardiovascular Secret Reference, PPORA, 2025. The Health Effects of Karate Training. A review of 21st century research, published in Healthcare. This new 2025 review found that karate training provides cardiovascular benefits equal to 70% heart rate intensity treadmill exercise, improves VO2 max, oxygen usage, strengthens the left ventricular myocardium, heart muscle. But here's what's fascinating. Kata, forms, and kumite, sparring, work differently. Kumite requires more metabolic power. It's like interval training built into an art form. Balance and fall prevention reference. Sullivan et al. 2024, Functional Benefits of Hard Martial Arts for Older Adults. A scoping review. Published in International Journal of Exercise Science. Australian researchers reviewed all studies on older adults doing karate. The results were unanimous. Significant improvements in balance, reduced fall risk, better functional fitness, over 80% adherence rate, people actually stick with it. Motor Skills Revolution, Arslan et al., 2024. The effect of 10 weeks of karate training on the development of motor skills in children who are new to karate. Researchers took 28 kids aged from 5 to 7 who had never done karate before. Half did karate for 10 weeks, half didn't. After just 10 weeks, significant motor skill improvements, better coordination, enhanced body control, improved balance. The control group, no changes whatsoever. How karate stacks up? Let me show you what the research says about karate compared to other activities. For cognitive function, better than general fitness. Witte et al. 2016, better than exercise and cognitive training. Jansen and Dahman Zimmer 2012, better than walking for executive function. Duras et al. 2015. For general health, lower injury rates than most sports, higher adherence than gym programs, more comprehensive benefits than single focus exercises. The perfect storm of benefits. Scientists have identified why karate is so powerful. Cognitive motor integration. You're learning complex patterns, kata, while moving. This creates new neural pathways. Interval training effect. Kumite provides natural high-intensity intervals. Social support. Training with others reduces isolation. Progressive challenge. Belt system provides constant goals. Mindfulness component. Awareness and focus on the present, including breathing, are built in. Whole body engagement. Every muscle group, every energy system. Look, I've shown you the results from over 30 studies. The science is crystal clear. Karate is safer than driving or playing soccer. It improves brain function. It reduces anxiety and depression. It strengthens bones and heart. It works for ages 5 to 85. The researchers aren't saying maybe anymore. They're saying karate is an efficacious intervention. Scientists speak for this stuff works. So here's my challenge. Find a local dojo. Try one class. Your brain, your bones, your mental health, your entire body will thank you. Remember, you're more likely to get hurt driving there than training there. So what's your excuse now? If you found this eye-opening, subscribe for more evidence-based health content. Share this with someone who thinks martial arts are too dangerous. Let's bust these myths together. And check out our other videos on lifestyle interventions, breathing techniques, and healthy diet, all backed by peer-reviewed science. This is Health Science for All, where we turn research into results.